अबुल पाकिर जलालुद्दीन अब्दुल कलाम वॉज एन इंडियन साइंटिस्ट हु प्लेड अ लीडिंग रोल इन द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ इंडियाज मिसाइल एंड न्यूक्लियर वेपन्स प्रोग्राम्स। ही सर्व्ड एज द 11th प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया फ्रॉम 2002 टू 2007। बॉर्न ऑन अक्टूबर 15, 1931 in Rameshwaram, Tamil Nadu, and studied physics and aerospace engineering at Madras Institute of Technology. Kalam wrote several books and received numerous awards. He was awarded the country's highest honors, the Padma Vibhushan in 1990 and the Bharat Ratna in 1997. He died on July 27, 2015 in Shillong, Meghalaya. So, students, in today's class, we are going to understand early childhood of our former president. APJ Abdul Kalam talks about his childhood days in this autobiographical account. He talks about his parents, his childhood friends, and his experiences at school. He grew up in a traditional society. People of different religions lived in that society. But in spite of different religions, people lived in peace and harmony. He was greatly influenced by his father, who taught him honesty and self-discipline. Written in a very humble and modest manner, the extract is very inspirational. The extract which we are going to read is from his book Wings of Fire. He talks about the people who became his role models, his parents, his teachers. He says that it doesn't matter who you are, if you have a vision and determination to achieve that vision, you will certainly do so. Saint Joseph College, Tiruchirappalli, and Aerospace Engineering at Madras Institute of Technology. A product of prestigious college of our country, he was honored for with prestigious awards for his exceptional contribution to the field of science. Abdul Kalam, when he was in class 5, took up a job, his first job rather, as a newspaper boy. And students, you will all be surprised or amazed rather to know that this boy would every day read the paper carefully so that newspaper would not get spoiled. And he says that first page always caught his attention because that was the time the Second World War had ended, and we were to achieve our independence. So the paper was filled with the photographs of fighter aircrafts and stories of Second World War, which really attracted him, or we can say that he took up this his studies in this aerospace science. He has written many books and poetries in his entire career. These are some of his quotes from his speeches. "We are as young as our faith and as old as our doubts. We are also as young as our self-confidence and as old as our fears." So we are as young as our hopes and as old as our despairs. "Finding an aim in life before you are 20 years old, acquire knowledge continuously to reach this goal. Work hard and persevere so you can defeat all the problems and succeed." I would like to ask you, what would you like to be remembered for? You have to evolve yourself and shape your life. Write your dreams on a piece of paper. That page may be a very important page in the book of human history. So these are the glimpses of some of his books written by him. Wings of Fire, India, Ignited Minds, Turning Points, Indomitable Spirit. All, I think, give a message of positivity. He has definitely left an indelible image on everyone's mind and heart. This autobiographical excerpt by the former president of the country, Dr. Kalam, shares some of his experiences from his childhood. He talks about the people who became his role models, his parents and his teachers. He learns humility and discipline from his father and kindness and charity from his mother. His teacher, Shiva Subramanyam Iyer, taught him an important lesson: to be persistent in face of challenges. The lesson shows us the impact that family, neighborhood, and school can have on children. It also shows us the change in an inevitable yet a gradual phenomenon. It takes time to let go of old, redundant habits, think rationally, and embrace change. So let us understand the early life of a former president. That's it for now. We will continue in the next class. Bye, all of you. Stay safe and stay healthy.